Hello friends, my name is Pradyuman and welcome to my channel VMware NSX Cloud, where I share step-by-step videos for VMware portfolio products. If you like what I shared in this video, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe because it helps me to grow the channel and so that I can continue to create quality content for you. In my previous video, we have reduced the number of NSX team managers. Remember, that is only needed for the lab environment. Do not reduce NSX team managers in production deployment. In this video, we will perform bring up of management domain. If you are doing it in lab environment, use that JSON file which we downloaded and updated. Or if you are deploying it in production, then use the deployment parameter Excel sheet. Unlike previous versions of VCF, this version gives us flexibility of choosing to deploy with BGP or static routes. Hence, it does bring up without edge nodes and AVNs. AVN stands for Application Virtual Network. Let's start with the cleanup of ESXi hosts, which might have stale entries due to validation which we cancelled or cleaned from the Cloud Builder database. We will have to remove entries from all participating hosts based on which step we have cancelled it. If you cancel validation in production deployment, only then you need to perform this step, but for the lab guys, it is a mandatory step. Once cleanup is done on all hosts, we can start with the management domain bring up. Remember, we have already cleaned Cloud Builder database, hence when we log in, it will show us end user license agreement. We need to accept it to move forward. Choose VMware Cloud Foundation in deployment type if you are deploying it on any hardware other than VxRail. Now you will be presented with all the prereqs needed for a successful VCF management domain bring up. Move next and download the deployment parameter sheet if you have not done already from VMware Customer Connect portal and populate all information in it. In my case, I am ready with the deployment file. Uploaded file will be verified and all configuration will be uploaded to the Cloud Builder for management domain bring up. Press next to start validation. You can log into Cloud Builder with SSH session and tail bring up logs to check detailed info on which task is in progress. In my lab, it took approximately 45 minutes to complete, but in production environment, it can take less time than this or maybe more than this, based on IP pools we have assigned in the deployment parameters, as it will do a ping test for each IP in the pool. So we will spend more time in validation if we have a big pool, less time if we have a small pool. Hence, always assign pool based on your requirement today with keeping future growth in mind, as you cannot expand the subnet IP pool after bring up. After validation of configuration, review error and warning and resolve if not correct. Then acknowledge the warning and start deployment of SDDC. Now, VMware Cloud Foundation will do its magic. You can go and get a cup of coffee or grab a snack. Meanwhile, VCF is deploying your SDDC. I would say VMware has done a really good job with VMware Cloud Foundation, as this product is a future-ready product. 15 years ago, portable data centers was just a myth, which is a reality since a decade. VCF is actual foundation for your hybrid cloud, as it has all the layers of a cloud. Secondly, whole SDDC bring up is controlled by workflows. You just provide required info and it creates a software-defined data center in a couple of hours with proper security hardening as per VMware best practice guides, which used to take days of work and man hours. It is a true SDDC as it has all the software-defined flavors, and with each release, VMware is adding features which makes it more user-friendly with ease of management. For instance, till previous version of VCF, you could only do on-demand password rotations, but now you can schedule it as periodic task. So no more password expiry because administrator forgot to rotate it. With version 4.3, you can do certain tasks in parallel, which was not possible in the previous version, such as creating multiple clusters in parallel. VMware VCF is getting mature with each release. Hence, do check what's new every time there is a new version in market. Well, in my lab, I'm running everything on nested environment. And my hardware server is a little old. So it took approximately 9 hours to complete the whole deployment, which I have shown you in this video by doing a fast forward. Once deployment is over, click on Finish button and log in onto SDDC Manager. That is it for today's video. In my next video, we will add Edge Node Cluster. Please feel free to leave feedback or suggestion in the comment section and do not forget to subscribe.